Hello everyone, this is the computer class and this is the first class for the class 8 and review class for grade 10. In this class we'll include some basic concept of computer, like how computer works, basic programming, program design tool and introduction to the QBasic. First let's see how computer works. In the computers, generally there are three units. One is input unit, next is central processing unit, and output unit. This input unit is specially designed to take the input from the user. There are many input devices like keyboard, mouse, a camera, trackball, trackpad, light pen. These all are the input devices. And these input devices are responsible in taking the input from the user and send it to the central processing unit for the further processing. In central processing unit, there are three units. One is memory unit, and next is control unit, and arithmetic and logic unit. Inside the CPU, these memories are the registers. In the central processing unit, there are many registers. These resistors are made up of millions of capacitors, and these capacitors are responsible in holding the charges in the form of 0 and 1. So these 0 and 1 are the data, that is 0 and 1 are the number. It is also called machine code that computer understand, and every instructions, every commands that is taken from the input devices are translated into the machine code and saved in the registers in the form of 0 and 1 in the form of charges. So charges, there are two types of charges. One is positive charges, next is negative charge. A positive charge means 1, that is also said to be on, and negative charge is off, that is also said to be off. And next is control unit. This control unit is responsible the controlling every operations inside the computer, and it also control the memory and arithmetic and logic unit. And next, this other arithmetic and logic unit is responsible in calculating arithmetic and logical operations. Arithmetic operations like mathematical operations, the calculations, addition, subtraction, division, multiplication, and other higher level of calculations can be done through arithmetic and logic unit. And finally, the data is processed and the result is obtained in the central processing unit, and it finally sent to the output unit. And there are many output devices like printer, monitor, speaker, etc. These all are the output devices. These output devices are responsible in giving the output to the user. Now next is how CPU, central processing unit, takes the data from main memory. Main memory means, we have to understand, random access memory and read only memory. There are two types of main memory. Let's assume to random access memory. When we start a program or when we open any file, first of all it load to the random access memory, and random access memory fetch the file to the central processing unit through a different level of cache memory. This cache level of cache are also the memories of smaller size. Level 1 is more smaller than level 2, and this level 2 is more smaller than level 3. So this main memory, especially random access memory, loads the file on it and send to the central processing unit for further processing. And next time if we open the same file, that file speed is quite faster due to this level of cache memory, because this cache memory hold the data for temporary purpose and makes the central processing unit surging fast, so that we will get the faster operations due to this level of cache memory. Now memory hierarchy. In computer systems, there are many levels of memory, and the more smaller memory is the faster memory, faster in speed. First is register memory. Like I said, the register memory are embedded inside the central processing unit, and these are responsible in taking the inputs from the input devices, and these are quite faster, and these are embedded to the CPU, that is central processing unit. Next is cache memory. This cache memory is also very near to the central processing unit, and which is responsible and taking the copy of the file for temporary purpose. Next is main memory. Main memory is also called the primary memory. Especially RAM and ROM are the primary memory. RAM is random access memory. It is the temporary memory. And next is ROM, read only memory. This read only memory is permanent memory, and which stores the system files of the computer systems. And when we start the computer, a booting process is loaded, and this all is due to read only memory. Next is magnetic disks. These are the hard disks and auxiliary memory. Magnetic disks and magnetic tapes are auxiliary memory, and these memories are higher in size, but its speed is quite slow. Now, programming basic. In the programming basic, we'll learn about the programming languages from the beginning. The first is machine level language. This machine level language is made up of only two digit, that is 0 and 1, and the machine understand only the machine level language. So machine level language is only 0 and 1, so it is called machine level language, because machine level language is directly understand by the machine without the use of any translator or language processing software. Second is assembly level language. It is a bit higher version of machine level language, and this assembly level language is made up of mnemonics like AID, SUB, SOB, etc. There are many mnemonics that makes the assembly level language, and this assembly level language is finally converted into machine level language with the help of language processing software called assembler. Assembler is one of the language processing software or language translating software that play the important role in translating assembly level language into machine level language. Next is high level language. This high level language is mostly used today, and for software development, this high level language is mostly used. There are many high level languages. QBasic is one of the high level language, which is of basic family. This basic family is developed by Microsoft Corporation in 1964. And in basic family, there are many other programming languages like GW Basic, QBasic, Visual Basic, Turbo Basic, and QBasic. Next is C. C is middle level language. It is also called structural language. Sometimes it behave like low level language, sometimes it behave like high level language. So it is called middle level language. And it is also called structural language, because in C language there is use of structure. So C is structural language. There are other high level languages like C++, Java, JavaScript, C Sharp, Python, R, Ruby, PHP, Kotlin, Objective-C, Swift, Dart, Flutter, React Native, ASP.NET. These all are the high level language. Other are also the high level language, but I have not mentioned here. These are the important and mostly used high level language in the present era or in present generation. So now I'm going to tell some of the important high level language. JavaScript is the important and most popular high level language, and Python is also quite important if we try to become a artificial intelligence If we try to work on artificial intelligence, robotics, and data science, this Python is quite important. And there are many other languages. This R is used for data science. PHP is used for backend development. Ruby on Rails. It is developed by Japanese developer and used for backend development. Kotlin. This Kotlin is for Android development. Launched by Google. Objective-C, this is the Apple's. Objective-C is launched by Apple, and it was used for Apple application development, but nowadays Swift is used for Apple, and this Objective-C is a older programming language, and the newest and latest programming language is Swift for Apple. And Dart, this is the programming language. It is quite faster, and the codes are similar like C. And Flutter, Flutter is programming language for hybrid application development. We can develop Android application as well as iOS application by the use of Flutter. React Native, this language developed by Facebook for the hybrid application development. Hybrid application means we can develop the application in Android and iOS as well. ASP.NET, this language is developed by Microsoft Corporation, and it is especially used for web development in the backend side. And this JavaScript is used for front-end development, only for the front-end. Java is a general purpose programming language used for every purposes, like embedded system. We can develop desktop application, web application, for the embedded system, for every purpose Java can be used, and for the mobile application development also we can use Java. Now, program design tool. In program design tool, we have to learn some tools that helps in writing the program. Before we write any program or before we design a software, first of all, we have to design. We use the design tool like algorithm, a flowchart, and pseudocode. These are the tools we can use while writing a program, or we can say before writing a program, first of all we need to think about the program. We have to design it. According to design, we have to make a program. Last is QBasic, and in this class we will just do the introduction of the QBasic. QBasic means the Quick Beginner's All-Purpose Symbolic Instruction Code, which is developed by Microsoft Corporation in 1964, and it falls under the basic family, that is Beginner's All-Purpose Symbolic Instruction Code. And QBasic is a high-level programming language. It uses interpreter as a language translating software. This QBasic is a high-level language. It means QBasic uses the English-like words and mathematical expressions, and these English-like words and mathematical expression is finally translated into the machine code, that is 0 and 1, with the help of an interpreter. Interpreter is a language processing software, and that machine code is finally executed to the computer and gives us output. In this way, we can write the program in the QBasic, and this QBasic is especially generally used by the students, the beginners level. For the beginners levels, QBasic can be used, and it is not practically used in present generation. For practical use, I have said many programming languages like C++, Java, JavaScript, and so on. But this QBasic is used only for learning purpose. We can make our basic, we can make our fundamentals. From the QBasic, we'll learn several things: how computer works, how program can be executed, how to write a program, what is variable, constant, keywords, character set, etc. These all are the basic things that we need to know before starting a program. So for today, I would like to close the topic. Thank you.